Okay, so we want to talk about leadership and why leadership is so important. In fact, I want to talk about community college leadership and at the CEO level and the significance there. And that's really the gist of our discussion today. But before we start into that, we have to ask ourselves, what is leadership? And looking at leadership, in its fundamental, in its core element, it's about motivating people. And specifically, we want to be able to motivate people to accomplish an objective or a goal. So if I'm a CEO in community college today, one of the things that happens for me is that in this 21st century community college element that we operate in, with all these different initiatives and funding that still continues to fluctuate, and then some of the challenges, of course, that our students have, is that I've got to figure out at a CEO level, how am I going to take this art form that I have and be able to put it into effect? And what I'm speaking about is leadership being like an art. And community college, and you could even say specifically community college in California, we don't have enough artists. So what are we going to do to be able to better utilize the artists that we have and at the same time put ourselves in a position to be more impactful for our students? So this is part of the 21st century leadership opportunity that series that I've built in bridge building for senior leadership. And the question we want to pose today to give you some ideas to how we approach this particular topic is why college CEOs leave and what, if anything, can be done about that. I'm Bernard Gibson. I'll be conducting the training for you today. One of the things I like to be able to do in this particular series is to scope the problem and understand what are the key elements that this problem in particular present. And so I do that in a number of ways. And I give you an example here. We could ask questions. So how many interim open management positions at your college or district are there? And you pause for a moment and you think about that. Do I know the answer to that question? Okay. Another way to help scope this in questions is to say, is there a simple or a complex situation from a leadership standpoint in the way that I'm approaching this particular topic that I can look for a solution or an answer? And then a third question I might ask is, then what's our strategy? How are we going to pull our resources together and be able to put ourselves in a position to map out a timeline to really complete our top three initiatives within the organization? So that starts to get us into the scoping, and you can do that in a number of ways in regards to questions, but have you identified the leadership champions in your organization or your institution? And these champions are very important. They're not the people that you always call upon to do something. They're the people that have the technical expertise, the skills, the temperament, and the ability from a leadership standpoint to help you drive the initiative. So it may not be someone that you normally call upon or someone that's been overlooked in your organization. And you need to pose these questions as a CEO to help you rethink your organization. So we then, after scoping, we then start to look at why are CEOs leaving? And there's tension. There's tension at the board of trustee level. There's faculty tension, which of course CEOs would be very familiar with. And there's leadership programs and mentoring. And I should back up just a little bit. Tension is not necessarily a bad thing. Tension is just based on the fact that you've got the element for opportunity to present itself and solutions to then be formulated if you can recognize how to work that tension. So think of it like a rubber band. If you stretch the rubber band too far, of course you affect elasticity and the ability for that rubber band to have its holding power. If you don't stretch it far enough, then you put yourself in a position where as a CEO, you're not getting the full depth and breadth of what that rubber band can do for you. But if you give it tension just right and be able to play back and forth with that rubber band, you find yourself in a position to understand how and when it can help your organization. And that goes into leadership. So what are some of the leadership programs and mentoring out there that are causing our CEOs to say, you know what, it's maybe too much for me to be able to handle, or that I would like to handle, and I move on to another organization or institution? So this becomes important in the grand scheme of what we're doing. And there are a few other things like job preparation and expectations that come into play here, but we'll get more into detail when we actually conduct the training in regard to this. So the next question that gets posed after we've scoped things and put ourselves in a position to then look at the problem question is, what can potentially be done? And when we're trying to get things done in our institution and our organization, we're always faced with questions about what is it that puts us in this position and why are we there constantly in our organization. So one of the things I like to think about is that when we are trying to figure out what can be done, we should be asking ourselves, when I look at my organization, who are the people, again, champions in my organization that can help me lead? What position are they in? Why are they in that position? And more importantly, how can they assist me and our institution in being able to effectively lead the entire organization? Let me give you an example. CEOs have to rely on vice presidents, executive vice presidents, people in very direct reporting and supportive roles of the institution. That doesn't mean that those individuals are the best individuals to be able to lead and help manage the college and the institution itself. So what is a CEO to do in regard to that? Well, usually you have a couple of options. One is, if you don't have enough people, then you might hire someone to be able to do that if you have positions open. If you have a scenario where you're inheriting people, then you've got to mentor and develop those people. Either way, you have to have a plan about how you're going to develop and pull your organization together. And we like to think of it in terms of you being able to understand, based on the situation you're presented with, how to get the best out of that. When we get into the depth and breadth of the training, we will give you more insight on how we tackle this specifically and what are some of the tools and resources that help you as a CEO in today's 21st century community college institution and environment be more effective and be a better leader.